to the today's topic of discussion, because again today also many of you would have joined newly. I am using Jupyter Notebook IDE, integrated development environment I am using, in which I am the presenter, Dr. Lakshmi. So it has the cell structure form. Whenever we are writing a code in a cell, we need to use press shift enter. We need to simultaneously press in order to run the code, or we can use this run button. Now each and every cell we can convert into markdown, heading or code. If we are writing Python code, we need to use code. If you are writing a text annotation, then we may need to use markdown or heading. Heading is for creating a heading, markdown is for creating a markdown. So this is the introduction. Then all the theory explanation and the foundation, how to create a variable, multiple assignment, operators, precedence and associativity, and how to know the data type of the object, every object, whatever we are creating in terms of Python, it is termed as object rather than it is termed as variable. The opt word in Python is object, because the entire Python programming language works in the principle called object oriented programming approach. Now these are all the set of arithmetic operators we have discussed yesterday. Today we are moving on to list data structure. That is where we stopped yesterday, list data structure. And slicing operator also we have discussed. Slicing operator is one of the important operator in order to work with string also, list also, any other looping statements also. It is one of the important structure. Slicing operator is one of the operator. I'm kept on admitting also. Then input function, yesterday we have seen input is useful for getting the input from the keyboard. It's a kind of passing on input to your program. I will be revisiting back in today's notebook also. Then we can, anything we use or we try to get input using input function, it is in the form of string data type that needs to be converted to the desirable data type. Then introduction to list we started with. This is what empty list creation or list initialization. Again, there are a lot of disturbance with the audiences. Yeah, let me come back. With the list data structure, we stopped at. Today, I continue from the list data structure. List data structure always it is represented within the square bracket. With that introduction, yesterday I have created a list data structure with a different data type, inclusive of floating data type, integer data type, string data type, all those things we have discussed. Now I change the notebook. Then I can continue with the next notebook for the today's topic of discussion. Somebody is trying to present Dayananda Mo. Why you are trying to present Dayananda? Okay, let us start with today's discussion. There is one interesting import function is available with Python. Import this Zen of Python. For the life, there is one philosophy called Zen philosophy. So it is like Zen philosophy for the life. For the Python, Zen philosophy like it is created. If you just type import this, it gives the Zen of Python. So it is telling that beautiful is better than ugly, explicit is better than implicit, simple is better than complex. Kindly mute yourself, audiences, those who are all unmuted. Please mute yourself. There are a lot of noise disturbance. Who is that? Okay, it will display just these are all the kind of text. Import this is the function. It's a kind of a package. Import is the keyword useful for including any package from the Python. This the moment we use this, it gives this list of conversations or dialogues, Zen of Python. With that, we start the session. A is equal to input. This A is equal to input is always useful for getting the input from the keyword. I will just execute this. So it is asking me to enter. Whatever we enter, whether it is 56 or it is Python, whatever we enter, these all termed as string data type. Enter. It just displays whatever I have typed. This is the prime role of input function. We need to remember input function always accepts only string data type. There is no other option. Like C language, you can't do integer with the percentage D, float with the percentage F, similar kind of thing we may not able to do with Python. Always it accepts string data type. That first thumb rule we need to remember. Subsequently, we are moving on to with input annotation. For the input, we are giving some annotation, some display. How we are trying to annotate or communicate, enter the input. I just execute this command, you will understand. See, it asks enter the input. Again, I am going to do that 6 o'clock, enter. It accepts 6 o'clock. If I want to convert the given input into integer, let me do the same command, need to be converted to the data type int. We are bracketing this entire input function and we are prefixing with int. That's it. We are converting the data type string to int. By the time, we need to give carefully only the integer. 566, if I give, no error will come. If I try to give float or any other thing, it will create error. So yesterday, this was demonstrated. I was trying to give 56.6. That is the reason we have got error. Otherwise, there is no error, eruption. So whenever we are mentioning int, the input should be appropriate data type. Now we are trying to get input and we are trying to convert it into int. Then we must give only this. If I give triple I, it accepts. Now float, what I'm trying to do, now this, in this input box, I'm trying to give 56.78. So it accepts float. Initially, the input whichever we type here is in the form of string. Subsequently, we are converting that input string in the form of float using explicit type conversion float. This is called type conversion. Explicit type conversion we are doing. Explicitly, we are mentioning that we are trying to convert from a string data type to integer data type. We are trying to mention here, we are trying to convert from string data type to float data type. That is how we are trying to tell. Now let us move on to revisit to the list data structure. This is one of the important data structure in Python. Although it has list, tuples, sets, dictionaries, and string, and array also it is possible here with Python. At the end of the session, I will give the comparative study among all those data structure. Let us start with the list. Anywhere, if you try to see this square bracket, it is termed as list data structure or data type. Anything you can call it as. Now I am creating trainees with empty list. I'm just creating the list name called trainees and I'm just initializing with empty square bracket. The moment I give empty square bracket, that signifies I'm creating empty list. Right now it is empty. We can add any list of element into it. Now how we are going to do one by one, let us see the demonstration. Very first name I'm trying to add is Pooja. I'm trying to add. Add means here append function, adding element to the list with respect to Python, we need to use append function. What it does, it starts appending to the list trainees. The first element would become Pooja. See, I'm going to execute these two lines. First line is creation of empty list. Second line is to add the element Pooja into the list. Third line is to print trainees or just to see what is available in trainees. In Jupyter Notebook, no need to use print function every time. how to use print function in the earlier session, yesterday's session, I have discussed in detail. You can watch that video. I just entered. See, the element which sits in trainee's list is Pooja. The very first element we have created into the list. There are several ways to fill the list element. Let us see one by one. Now, second, what I am trying to do, trainees.append, Mohammed, trainees. Now, let us see. The same list has two names, Pooja, the same order, subsequent order, Mohammed. Next, I am trying to add element, Rajani. Then, Pooja, Mohammed, Rajani. Then, subsequently, I am doing just a series of append function. Nothing else I am doing, only series of append function. Next, I am trying to add append Guru. Then it is trying to do. Now this is called not append function. It is called update. I'm updating the existing content. What is the meaning of update? I'm telling the index value and I'm asking to replace the second position information by Guru. This is position number 0. Pooja will become position number 0. Mohammed will become position number 1. This will become position number 2. Index starts from 0 to maximum limit, max limit, that's all. So 0 shows the lower limit, max limit up to your choice, how many element you would like to add in. Now we are trying to do trainees of 2 equal to Guru, then we are trying to print. You look at the difference. Here the list of elements are different, Pooja, Mohammed and Rajani. Now this option after the update, it becomes Guru. So that is a change in element happens. We are trying to update this. This process is called update. I will put it in heading so that you can see better. So update index. The index always starting from 0 to the maximum limit. This is a fundamental idea you may need to have about list. Now another way. I don't want to use append every time. Then how can I initialize list? Sample. I need to change it into code. I'm going to give sample equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes. Now it becomes list. Simple list having these are all the elements. Enter. Now it displays all the element. Now let us move on to how to delete element. Pop is the function useful for deleting the last element of the list. It deletes, also it informs what element it is deleting. Look at, I'm just going to execute. Earlier, Guru was the last element. This has been deleted. After deleting, it's the rest of the elements are displayed. I will do this little bit later. One more cell I'll do. Now I'm going to execute just pop function alone. It says, I'm deleting Mohammed. Pop function always says you which element it is deleting. The second, now after that, I'm trying to do Pooja. This is how pop function works. There is del function. I'll be explaining that also shortly. The del function is to delete, but it will not inform us which it is deleting. Now reverse. This is inbuilt method. This method will reverse the items, whatever the item. Now I'm going to use sample instead of trainees. Sample. I created sample with 1, 2, 3, 4, you would have seen. Now it is going to become in the reversal order, sample.reverse, enter. 4, 3, 2, 1, it reverses. This one simple function is sufficient in Python in order to reverse the content of the given list. List either you can create with the empty bracket, subsequently you can append. You can get input also using append and input combination. You can get input from the keyboard also. I will give you it as an exercise. You all need to try using input function. You need to and using append function together. You need to get input from the keyboard one by one and you need to create a list. This is what today's exercise you need to do. I don't demonstrate combining those two. Input and append together, I will not be doing. I explained input separately, append separately. You may need to sit and do today how to get input from the keyboard and how to append those input into the list. That is the exercise I'm giving you today. Now let us move on to the other already we have mentioned updating, updation of the list. Now accessing values in the list. Look at, there are two lists I have created. List one contains physics, chemistry, 1997, 2000, some year, some data. We can delete this semicolon also. We can retain semicolon also as the continuation. This, the moment we put a semicolon, it continues. List two is going to become, let me delete the semicolon. List two contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'm trying to print the function using print function. This is the display text. Nothing to worry. Whatever you like, you can write. Otherwise, you can skip that display text portion. Directly, you can concentrate on what you want to display. I am expecting to display list one of zeroth element. The result would become physics, because always I said in the list index starts from zero. So that if we use list one of zero, that would print the first element of the list. Now, what is the first element of list one? Physics is the first element. That is zeroth index. Now, second print function, we are giving some display text here within the double quotation. List two of one slicing operator two. Yesterday, someone asked during QA session, is it possible to use slicing within the list? Yes, it is possible. Now, that is a demonstration. List two of 1 to 5. Always understand in the slicing operator after the colon, whatever we give before 1, minus 1, it will end. It will end with minus 1 because the index starts from 0. Now look at list 2 and rehearse in your mind what would be the output. It starts from 1.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Sir. Yes, sir.
Kindly look into the voice quality.
I am not able properly. To. I cannot do beyond that anything, sir, because that flaw of the software, that you need to admit, sir, please. I am nearly exhausted. Even I used to drive the session for 4.5 hours to 6.5 hours. For this 1 hour itself, I am feeling difficulty because of the software.
What I request you, ma'am, with small examples, make this session more interactive with students.
Yeah.
So it will that be beautiful.
Yeah. Now. Already executed. So now, okay, 1 to 5. 1 is the lowest index and 5 is the highest index. That highest index stops minus 1, I said. Now I request you to give me the answer. Now, what I'm going to do is list 2 of 3:5. What would be the result? Before execution, you may need to use the chat box and you need to tell. Look at the list one. This is the elements available in list one. Sorry, list two. List two, 3 to 5. You need to explain me what would be the output of this statement. 3 slicing operator 2. You can refer this as a reference point. List two of 1 to 5. Now list two of 3 to 5. What would be the answer? Let me look at the chat box. 4, 5, 5, 6. So many combinations they were telling. 4, 5, 6, 4, 5. Yeah, 4, 5, 6 also you are telling. It starts from index 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. It stops at minus 1, I said. So that 4, 5 would be the right combination for this statement. Let me execute it. See, 4, 5. 4, 5 is the right combination. Hope you will be understanding what is this slicing operator. One more example let me give so that you can understand better. I'm going to add one more element here, 55 also. Now I'm going to ask you list 2 of 4:7 close bracket. Look at list 2. List 2 consists of the element 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 55. What would be the answer for this 4:7 slicing operator? You can make use of the chat box for the communication. Yeah, after the course, I will share with you video and the slides. Definitely already. Yeah, 5, 6, 7. Let us move on. 5, 6, 7. Let me look at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the 4. Then 6th, after 4, 5, 6, it should stop at 6. 5, 6, 7 is the right answer. Because the last index, maximum limit always ends with minus 1. With the minus 1 stoppage, we need to think of 4 to 7. Now, another question you may need to ask. The index which is not at all available, if I try to access, what would happen? Error will happen. I will demonstrate for that. Insert below. Now, list 2 of 5:11. What is the meaning of 5:11? There is no 11 element. If you look at the number of elements are less than 11. 7, 8 elements only available. But I am trying to give the index value up to 11. Let us see what would happen. 6, 7. It shows, there is no error. It starts at 5 and it ends with 11. We are trying to access from the 5. Then 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6th is the 5th location. Then it completes the remaining portion to display 5 to 11. So this is slicing operator with list combination. Next, we are going to look at list equal to physics chemistry. This is the initialized year. Printing the display text, then print list of 2. It prints you 1997. Whenever we use print function with the display text separately and the print function subsequently, we no need to use new line character with Python. Automatically, it redirects to the next line. The list of 2 element will be printed with 1997 here. New value available at index 2. Next, we are asking for the next index, then we would be getting 2001. Now, deleting the list. Already we have seen delete operation, list deletion. What is the operation we have seen? Deleting the element. Could you type anyone, please? Deleting the element from the list, what we have seen? Pop. Exactly. Thank you. Pop is the function used for deleting the element. It will inform us what element it is going to delete. Then it will delete, or after the deletion, it will inform us. Whereas delete function will not inform. Another advantage with delete is the specified index value will be deleted. The difference between del and pop, let us write. Del is useful for deleting the specified element. Which element we want to delete, it will delete. Pop is useful for deleting the last element of the list. It will delete last element of the list. That is the only difference. Now let us look into this. First, list 1, physics chemistry 1997-2000. Print list 1. Semicolon is not required. No way semicolon is required when we work with Jupyter Notebook. Print list of 1. Delete list 1 of 2. See, this is before deletion. This is after deletion. Let me write one more print function also. Before deletion and after deletion. Then you may be able to understand. Look at now. The specified location to be deleted is element number 2. This is element number 0, element number 1, element number 2. This element 1997 is deleted. After the deletion, we are obtaining the rest of the list. That is the purpose of del command. Whereas the pop method is useful for deleting the last element of the list. Now, one more list we are trying to create, L. L is equal to Python small letter and capitalized word and completely capitalized. Now we are trying to access L of 2. L of 2 would be giving what? Would be giving Python. The last element would be the output. Now what is the meaning of L of minus 2? Yesterday I have given one clue for this. This is called negative indexing. Concept is available in Python. This is useful for accessing the elements from the end of the list. That we should remember. always minus is useful for accessing from the end of the list. What is the minimum index value? Minimum index value is minus 1. Look at this Python. What would be the index value for this capital Python? What would be the index value? Please text me in the chat box. Capital Python is there, na? Yeah, minus 1, exactly. It is useful for accessing from the end. Del list of 1 to 4, it won't do for range of element to be deleted. Nayak, this is the answer for you. Del will delete one element at a time. It will not delete range of element at a time. Now, what is the index, negative index value to access this? Tell me, negative index value to access this. Or what is the output of this? Tell me, L of minus 2. L of minus 2, what would be the output? L of minus 2. What would be the output? Python, exactly. Very good. Capitalized Python is the output of L of minus 2. Let me execute this. See. Now, what is the output of this? All the foundations we have seen. L of 1 colon. Look at the element L. L of 0, 1, 2. What is the output of L of 1 colon? Exactly, Sweta, very nice. Python minus 1, Python minus 2, Python minus 3. Yeah, L of 1 colon, 1 colon, 0, 1 colon. Last two elements would be the answer. Because end limit we didn't mention. We are mentioning about beginning of the requirement. We are not mentioning about end of our requirement. So the index value starts with 0. This is 1, this is 2. We mentioned about the beginning, 1. We didn't mention about the end value. So we would be getting Python, Python. Now, let us look into some other methods of list data structure. Once again, I am creating list 1 equal to John, physics, chemistry, 80 marks, 90 marks. There is no interpretation. We only need to give interpretation. List 2. David, physics, chemistry, 70, 99. Now, I need to execute this cell in order to make these all values to be initialized into list 1, list 2. Now, there is a method called len or function. You can call it as function also. If I execute, it will give the length of the list 1. See, 5 elements are available. Now, I'm going to add one more. 6 o'clock. I need to put it in double quotation or single quotation either. Now look at the length of list 1. Now I have modified. Now length of list 1 would become 6. This is the use of length function. We no need to calculate using a minor program how to count the number of elements available in list. Now tell me what is the output of this len of list 2. What is the output of this? Yeah, 5. Exactly. 5 is the output of length of list 2. Let us execute 5. Now, I am switching over to one more list. You may feel strainful, but nothing to worry. You will have different examples. Nums, I am creating as one more list. I am initializing with 11, 51, 22 and so on. Nothing to worry what is available here. Look at, there is a function max. Max, open bracket, I need to pass list object. This is said to be, even in the syntax when you are studying, they will mention object. Then I am passing on here. Then max of the list name I am going to pass. Now what would happen? It is going to give max of, why 900? 900 I haven't mentioned. Nums 11, 51, 1 minute, nums. Yeah, 158. It is updated. 158. Now I'm going to delete 158 here. Please tell me what is the output now. If at all I am going to execute max. Yeah, very fast, you people. 67, fantastic. 67 would be the output. Similarly, there is a function called min. Min will give us the minimum value of the list. The minimum value available in the list is 11. Now let us look into nums dot count of, this is the object, this is the list name. The object which we are passing is 11. It is going to count how many times it occurred in the specified list. That is the meaning of count. 11 and 11, two times it has been mentioned. So it is going to be, the output is going to be 2. Whatever the answer you are seeing that I have executed previously, now it gives a output 2. Now I'm going to do once again 22, 22, enter. I have updated the list. Now tell me 22, if I give, what would be the output of this function? 22 nums dot count of 22. What would be the output? Yeah, 3. Very good. 3 is the expected output of this function. That is fine. Now, earlier we have seen append function. Append is to add element by element. Another comparison. Append is useful for adding one element at a time. This is the core purpose of append. Now we are going to look at another function, that is extend. The purpose of extend is to give the extension of list 1 to list 2. It will be appended. List 1 will be appended with list 2. Now already we have compiled this list 1, list 2. Here list 1, list 2. John and David list we have compiled. Once again I will execute this cell. Now it is initialized with this value with list 1, these values with list 2. Now let us see here list 1 extend list 2. Only one time I am going to execute. Now list 1 I am going to display. Now what it would be? See, it is just appending the information about John. Subsequently it is appending David. If I run this cell once again, it will keep on appending list 2. Don, David information will be appended n number of times. That is the meaning of executing this cell again and again. Look at list 1 dot extend of list 2. List 1 holding the information about academic credential about John. List 2 holding the academic credential about David. That is what we have seen. Now what we are going to look at is, we are using this extend function. Now it is going to become appended. The result is available with list 1. That is what you need to make a note. Result will not go to list 2. List 2 will not get disturbed. List 1 only going to get disturbed. Now list 1 already have this information. See, I'm going to execute this once again. Now this, look at David is included two times. This is also David. This is also David. Two times it has been extended. As many times you execute this cell, that many times it will start extending. That is the information. Now let us see nums once again after all the updation. Why I am creating nums once again? I am going to explain one more function, insert. This append is useful for inserting the element at the end of the list. And insert is useful for inserting element at the specified location. That is the difference. Now I will look at fifth location need to be updated as 900. That is what I mean to say. Enter, executed. Rehearse your mind. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This 22 is going to be replaced, or not replaced, sorry, it will be pushed to that next level. Instead of this 22, 900 would be displayed here. Look at 900 is inserted between 22 and 22. One more time, if I execute the same function, what would happen? One more time, if I try to execute that cell, what would happen? Yeah, minimum value, one time only it will show. N number of times it can occur, but it will show only one time. Minimum value position we may not able to get. For that, we need to write the coding. Position is not possible. With the inbuilt, with the inbuilt coding, it is not possible to get index value of the minimum element. Only the minimum element we used to get. For combining or to get minimum value, there are another function we need to combine together, then we can get. If I execute this function once again, what will happen is the question. That insert function is there, no? Nums insert 5, 900, what will happen? Not same. No. That 900 will be pushed to the right side. One more 900 will go and sit. How I set for extend? The same way. 2900 exactly. Now I execute. Look at this is what the present in output. Now I am going to execute this once again. Now, first I need to execute this. Then I need to execute this. See, 2900. The moment we keep on executing this cell, it assumes that user is expecting me to insert 900 at the fifth position. That's all. Nothing more. Now let us go to sort function. Now I am creating one more list A1, consists of 11, 2, 33, 4, whatever you want, you can include. What we need to do, list name, name of the list A1, dot sort, then A1. It gives you sorted order. Now I'm going to include one more element, comma, 0, comma, 444. Look at this. This is the input. After applying sort function, it's going to become sort. Sorted, 0 element comes first, 2, 3, 4. This is the use of sort function. Now let us see one more practice. Slowly we are entering into for loop with the list combination. My list equal to empty list. My list of append is 1. Before that, I will ask one question. We have discussed two things, insertion and deletion. Now you need to give me answer. What is the answer I will ask you? Insertion, inserting element at the last is what is the function? Inserting element at the specified location or position. Now you need to give me the answer in the chat box. Inserting element at the end of the list, inserting element at the specified location. What are all the functions? First one, you give first, second one, you type second. Append is for last, insert is for specified. Excellent. Yeah. Append is for, then syntax you should remember, but I am writing here append. Insert function is to insert. Similarly, deletion. Deleting the element at the last. Deleting the element at the specified location, what are all the functions? Next, pop del, excellent. Pop is a function useful for deleting end of the element. Then the second function, del is a function useful for deleting the specified element location. Now, what is the use of extend function? Extend is useful for what? appendix for insertion, insert is also for insertion. Yeah, come joining two list, that's all, combining two list. Excellent. Now let us move on to, with that introduction, we move on to next. Now append, we are doing append of one means it will be inserted. The first element would become two, second element would become, sorry, first element would become one, second element would become two and three and so on. Now we are trying to print after the insertion in the same order we are trying to print, 1, 2, 3. Now I will move on to this next, so that you will understand the for loop functionality also. Look at 1, 2, 3 is the answer for all of us. This function, print of my list of 0, print of my list of 1, print of my list of 2. Now I am going to show all the element together how to print we are going to look at. Just I need to give my list, enter. It gives me all the element. Using this print statement, we use the index value for the accessing of the given list. My list displays all the elements. Now let us look into for loop. The syntax for for is for, and this is a variable going to control the looping construct x. In is a membership function. It will pick the element from the list my list. We need to remember, whenever we use for statement, it should end with a colon. This is mandatory. For statement, always we must end with a colon. This is a mandatory procedure with Python. So far now, I didn't use any of the delimiter. Delimiter, first time I'm using, the delimiter is colon. This is the first time I'm talking about delimiter. Never ever I said delimiter so far now. Now, for, this is the looping control variable. In is the membership function. My list is the list. Then colon. Now using this for statement, we are going to print the list of elements which are all available in the my list. My list consists of 1, 2, 3. If you are getting confused, I will change this also 11, 20, 33. Instead of 1, 2, 3, always it is better for better way of understanding 11, 20, 33. I'm going to give enter. Now you remember that first element is 11, second is 20, third is 33. My list also having the same. Now how I am accessing through membership operator and looping construct is the question mark. I am printing x. What x will do is, x will go and pick up the value, first value from the list for the first time of execution. Subsequently, if x will fetch the value, second element of the list 20, x will fetch the value, third element of the list 33. That would be the result. Now carefully look at another caution. This space is required. This is said to be indentation. Four spaces are mandatory in Python. What is the meaning is, print statement is going to get executed under the control of this for statement. Now I am going to execute this. Look at 11, 22, 33. How it is happening? X, first time when the for loop is executed, X will go and refer or fetch the first element of the list, my list. Then that is, that will be placed in x. That x is printed using print function. Again, this looping construct continues. Second time, x will access the second element of the list. Then it prints that. Again, the loop continues until the list becomes empty or it reaches the end of list. Then x becomes 33. It prints 33. It won't execute further. Even if it executes fourth time, there is no more element with the list, it exits. How it exits? That is why yesterday I rehearsed in membership function. It will, membership function always identify true or false, Boolean value. Then x tries to access one more time, it returns false because the list completes with the three element, no more element exists in the list. So that the loop is going to stop. So this is the way for loop functions. Now let us move to little bit higher construct of the program. Now I am going to assign or create one object midpoint, assign with the value 5. Now this becomes naturally integer. Already I said, depending upon the value which we assign on the right hand side RHS, the left hand side variable will become the data type in Python. Now we are creating two empty lists, lower and upper. Now what we are trying to do for loop, we are going to divide the elements, upper end means what to say, lower element and upper element. We are going to fill the list. Now for loop we are going to use I is the control variable, looping control variable, in is the membership operator, range now only I'm trying to introduce. This is one of the important function in Python. Range is one of the important function. Range of 10. Now before that I need to demonstrate to you what is a range. Range of 10 means this will generate a value 129, that we need to remember. Always it generates minus one value, 129. If I don't mention the lower limit, it will start from 0, upper limit minus 1, 0 to 9. I haven't mentioned any of the lower limit. I can give like this also, 1 to 1 colon 9 also I can give with the slicing operator. Let us see one by one. Range of 10 colon, already I mentioned delimiter is mandatory for construct. Then if, now we are introducing control statement, yet another statement. If is the control statement, for is looping statement. If, open bracket, I, this control variable, less than midpoint. What is the value of midpoint? 5. What we are trying to tell, less than 5, we are accumulating it into one list. Greater than 5 or greater than or equal to 5, we are accumulating it into another list. That is what we are trying to do. Now, lower list we are using in order to append the I value if I value falls less than 5. Else, we are appending that I value with upper list. Upper is yet another list. There are two lists we have created. Now, print lower. This is display text, nothing to worry. We are trying to print the list lower. We are trying to print the list upper. Now, I execute this. Look at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 comes falls to here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 falls to here. Now slowly I will increase the complexity of the range. Then you need to explain me. Instead of this 5, I'm going to use it as 8. Understand? The midpoint I'm giving 8. Now the range value I'm going to give 2 colon 11. Now you need to tell me only the lower list. What would be the output of the lower list? 2 is the beginning value of the range. 10 is the ending value of the range. Although I give 11, technical point of view, it is going to become 10. Understand? I said minus 1 already. Now we are using slicing operator. That is the only change. With the slicing operator, I am modifying the range starting with 2, ending with 10. Now you need to tell mid value I have put 8. Now what would become the output of lower list? Lower, exactly, excellent. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, so many are so active. 2 to 7 also somebody mentioned, excellent. That's it. Now let us see the output for this line number 2. Minute. Range of 2 colon 11. Invalid syntax. Range function doesn't allow. Slicing operator, it is not allowing here. Then we must choose with 11 only, 11 or whatever. It's not allowing here the slicing operator within that. Slicing operator is permitted in the for loop. I will come out with that syntax in the tomorrow session. Now I have modified 13. 13 is splitting with the 8 value. With respect to 8, it splits 0 to 7 and 8 to 12 in the other list. Now this all we have seen. One more way of writing expression, arithmetic expression is x plus equal to 2. I am going to give x is equal to 10. Next I am using the function, using the expression x plus equal to 2, enter. X would become 12. This is equivalent to x is equal to x plus 2. This is the meaning. This is shorter form of assignment statement. This is the expansion, real expansion, x is equal to x plus 2. Similarly, we can do for minus also, we can do for subtraction also, addition also, division also. This is the shortest notation of arithmetic assignment statement. Now, in the day one, I said, if you want to continue, fold the line of the code. If the line of the expression becomes larger, you need to use backslash I mentioned. So just simply add 1 to 8. You are telling explicitly all the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that it adds all the number. This backslash is useful for telling the interpreter continue with the previous line. The line of execution continues further. That is the indication. This, let us see whether it is executing or not. It is accepting. Otherwise, you may need to use bracket. Now let us move on to midpoint. Again, append of the same only. Now it is going to add the code from 1 to 100. This is a code for adding 1 to 100. Total is not defined. I need to mention total first. Total equal to 0. Now if I execute, it gives me the answer. Final line, I need to use here total in order to print. What it does is total is initialized with 0. Then naturally total will become integer data type. Then for is a looping construct. I in range of 100. Indentation we are using. Total is equal to that plus sign, plus equal to that assignment operator we are trying to demonstrate here. That's all, total. Now you can explain me now what is the answer or output of this. Total equal to 5. For I in range of 5, colon, total plus equal to I, total. What is the output of this construct? 15, fantastic. Let us see the output of this. 10. What are all the element? 0, 1, I need to use commentary line. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. It won't execute 5. So that the answer is 10. 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. If we use 5 only, then it will become 15. But range function, I said it starts from 0, ends at minus 1 value. If you give like this, there is no problem. Lot of space, if you give, it stripes. It removes. It doesn't matter for Python. It gives me 3. If you write like this, there is no issue. Instead, how you need to write? Like this you need to write. X is equal to 1 plus 2. So space is not a problem when you are doing normal expression. But when you are having loop construct and control statement, if and looping statement for, then this indentation is mandatory. If also it is mandatory, for also it is mandatory. For statement. In this previous case, you would have seen all the indentation. If you look at for comes in normal flow of execution, within for if comes, so that indentation. Within for and if construct, lower dot append comes. There are two statements controlling the power of append. Then else is equivalent to if, but it is under the control of for. Then under the control of for and else, this statement is executed. This is called indentation. Every level of indentation should be prefixed with four spaces. Here four spaces are prefixed, here eight spaces are prefixed. Every level, further sublevel, need to be indicated with four space indentation. That is the only difference between the conventional language which we learned and here. Most of the stuff are repeating only. Append. Now we are asking the question, x is equal to 4.5. This is one of the method, inbuilt method. X dot is integer. Is integer is kind of membership function. Now what would be the answer is false, because 4.5 is floating data type, whereas second one it will give true, because 4.0 you can give, 4.8 anything you can give. The moment it sees dot, it says true. 4.5 integer false. Now is integer true. It's supposed to become true. Yeah, is integer. Yeah, it is not integer. Now I delete this one. Let us see. X is equal to 4. X is underscore integer. Int object has no attribute, is integer. Okay. 4.0. Then it gives integer. Anything after dot, fractional values are available, it gives false. After dot, if it has 0, it gives true. These are all the two inbuilt functions in order to verify, especially when you do data science, you may need to verify the range or some identities, some occurrences or instances. By the time, these are all the function will be useful. Otherwise, standalone, it is not at all useful. Yeah, almost we reached 6 o'clock. I come to QA session. Then subsequently, tomorrow we are going to start with tuple data structure. Tuple is yet another data structure. Now almost deeper driven, we moved on with list data structure. Tomorrow we are going to look at tuple. Tuple is the next data structure we are going to look at tomorrow. How tuple will look? If you wish, I can start now, little bit introduction. A is equal to open bracket 1, 2, 30.5, open bracket 6 o'clock, open quotation. Now I am going to print A. It gives whatever the value available in tuple. End of value string letter tuple 1, 2, 30.3. yeah, here I unnecessarily I gave. So this is a tuple. I come to the conceptual understanding of tuple tomorrow. Only the difference is, instead of that square bracket in tuple, we will use parenthesis. The moment we say list, we need to remember this bracket. The moment we say tuple, we need to remember this bracket. But the core notion of tuple and list is going to become different. That part, let us discuss, start with the difference between these two. Why they have introduced tuple, all those stuff, we will start with the tomorrow session. With that end note, I'm going to stop today's session. If you have any question answer, we can have discussion. Yeah, 4 and 4.0 both are same, I agree, but it is not accepting without that decimal value. It is not accepting, Subrat Kumar. It is not accepting. In front of you, I did know it is not accepting. So there are a lot of intricacies we need to understand with Python. I will share with you one book. Data set would start when? Data set I would be starting last day. That is day after tomorrow. Tomorrow I will be quickly walking through all other data structures like tuple, sets, dictionary, string, etc. Last day I will be demonstrating how to read the data, how to access the data and look at the data summary. These are all those things. Very rudimentary level of data science or data accessing only we are completing with this 5 days webinar. Yeah, it's accepting numbers only with the decimal format, with the decimal format only, because those are all the constraints it is designed already. Yeah, any more questions? Then we can wind up if you wish to communicate. I request all of you to join with the WhatsApp group with the link. Only then I can share with you learning resources. This notebook also, Jupyter notebook also, I will share in the WhatsApp group. You can use that Jupyter notebook. You need to open it with the Google Colab or Kaggle or Jupyter notebook. Three method you need to open the notebook without any other software. If you try to do, when is the advanced topics, that is depending upon the organizer, and any other workshops are there with data science, I will inform you, Sweta. Already I have created 40 hours of data science video, and you can watch that in my YouTube channel. Data science video is available. I can share that link also in the WhatsApp group. You please join in the WhatsApp group. That is the only way. I request Mr. Karnavaran to post the WhatsApp link in the chat box. WhatsApp joining link. So that is the only way I can connect with you all. Even you can make use of that group for references or communication, intimations, and a change of link or anything. Without WhatsApp group, it is very tough to coordinate with a different category of people, so that all, both students and faculty, whomever taking part in this session, I request you to join the WhatsApp group, so that there we can do all the moderations and the communications. Thank you all. Tonight I will be sharing this Jupyter notebook and a few books for references. That is branded book. Professionally, you can groom yourself. The WhatsApp link is shared here. Any one of you wish to join with that group, you are welcome. Yeah, with a Google Colab, you can open the notebook which I am using. Otherwise, you need to have Jupyter notebook installation, or else you need to go to Kaggle. Kaggle is a platform. You can create an account, and we are two with the Google Colab. Or two others, ma'am. Yeah, I will type. Enough, Karnakaran sir. Stop posting. Enough. Kaggle is one method of doing. Google Colab is another method of doing. Jupyter notebook is another method of doing. These are all the three methods. Jupyter notebook we need to install. Kaggle and Google Colab online platform, we should have Gmail account. That is more than enough. In my first day video, I have shared how to work with Google Colab. Otherwise, just Google it. There are plenty of videos demonstrating how to work with Google Colab. Just Google it, you will come to know how to work with Google Colab. With that note, I sign off from you all. Since I am the host, the moment I log off, you all will be logged out. Have a good day. See you all tomorrow by 5 o'clock. Bye.